Hello everyone, and thanks for taking the time to check out this video. For today's installment of my ongoing series on SKS pattern carbines, I'm going to be showing you the right way to establish the date of manufacture on your State Arsenal 26 Type 56 carbine. So right off the bat, if you've been told that you can date your Type 56 by taking the millionth place of the serial number and adding that to 1956, at best you're off by a year, and at worst you're off by more than a decade. That's because even when that particular rule works, people are using the formula wrong. Chinese Type 56 production began in 1956, so using that as the base for the formula doesn't give you years of production, it gives you years since production, and that's not how people keep track of time. For example, if you add the number 2 to 1956, you get 1958, suggesting that the third year of production was designated with the number 2. Which makes no sense. Obviously, the correct formula would be to add the millionth place to 1955, but unfortunately, even this only works some of the time. The good news, however, is that thanks to the diligent research and observations of communities such as SKS files, we can positively ID any State Arsenal 26 carbine, and I hope this walkthrough video will make that process as streamlined as possible for you. So without further ado, grab your Triangle 26 Type 56 carbine and follow along with me, and I'll do my best to tell you exactly which year it was made. Step 1, direct your attention to the exposed left sidewall of the receiver and look for a Triangle 26 Arsenal mark, clearly pictured here. The exact size or location of that stamping may vary, but it will be somewhere on that left sidewall. Pay especially careful attention to identifying the numerals 2 and 6, as there are other Chinese arsenal marks which look similar, such as this triangle 016 arsenal mark. If this mark is not present on your rifle, we may still be able to date your carbine, but you will need to skip ahead in this video, so go ahead and pull up the chapters to this video and look for a chapter titled No Arsenal Stamp. For everyone else who has identified the Triangle 26 Arsenal stamp on their weapon, we can move forward now. The next thing I need you to do is inspect your barrel lug. The barrel lug can be found below the rear sight assembly, forward of the receiver, and rearward of the point at which the rear sight assembly interfaces with the barrel. I always defer to the barrel lug when dating a Type 56 carbine, because unlike components such as the bayonet or stock, it's pretty much impossible for a layman to replace or swap out. When looking at the barrel lug, there are three variations which you could theoretically observe. The first is no barrel lug, more commonly referred to as a pinned barrel. If this is what's present on your rifle, you do not actually have an Arsenal 26 carbine and we can't date it. Either you've made a mistake in identifying the arsenal mark from the previous step, or you most likely have a commercial carbine assembled from military surplus parts, which for whatever reason were not properly sanitized of those military markings. The next variant you might observe is what we call a long barrel lug, or a long lug. As seen in the inset picture, the long lug fills up approximately 90% of the space between the receiver and the rear sight assembly, and very little of the barrel is exposed in this gap. If this is what's present on your carbine, go ahead and pull up the chapters to this video and click on the chapter titled Arsenal Stamp Long Lug. For everyone remaining, what you should be seeing is what we call a short barrel lug, or short lug. While the exact geometry and profile of this component will vary, the key to identifying a short lug is that it covers approximately 50% of the space between the receiver and the rear sight assembly, leaving approximately 50% of the barrel exposed in this gap. If your rifle has a Triangle 26 stamping and a short barrel lug, you are looking at the production years of 1964 through 1980. Dialing down exactly which year is a pretty simple task and will require you to bring your attention to your serial number, which should be numeric and either 7 or 8 digits long. If your serial number is 8 digits long, we can take those first 2 digits, or the million places, and add those to 1955 in order to derive your date of manufacture. You can refer to the chart on screen for your specific serial number, but basically we're looking at the numbers 10 through 14 corresponding with 1965 through 1969, and the numbers 23 through 25 corresponding with 1978 through 1980. If your 7-digit serial number begins with a 9, it's just as simple. We add that 9 to 1955, and we get your date of manufacture is 1964. Now the place where it gets a little bit more complicated is if your 7-digit serial number begins with a 1, because all of a sudden our trusty formula stops working. No, your short-lugged, triangle 26 marked Type 56 carbine was not made in 1956, despite what the internet may have told you. You actually need to now include the 6th digit or 100 thousandths place, because for whatever reason in the early 1970s the Chinese got a little lazy and dropped a digit. Once we include that number, which for you should be a 5 or a 6, all of a sudden we get 15 and 16 and things start to make sense again. So if you've got a 1.5 million serial number, you're looking at a production date of 1970. And if you have a 1.6 million serial number, you're looking at a production date of 1971. So that covers all of our bases for short lugs. Now let's talk about long lugs. Well, if your triangle 26 stamped carbine has a long barrel lug, we're looking at production years of 1957 to 1964. To know exactly which year in that range, once again, just requires that we take a look at your serial number. You may have a 7-digit numeric serial number or a 4-digit numeric serial number with a Latin letter prefix. If you've got a 7-digit numerical serial number, we can go back to the formula from the beginning of this video to derive the date of manufacture. You can refer to the chart on screen for your specific serial number, but basically we have the numbers 2 and 3 corresponding to 1957 and 1958, and the numbers 6 through 9 corresponding to the production years of 1961 through 1964. If your serial number is 4 digits with a Latin prefix, then we're looking at the production years of 1959 and 1960. With a high probability that the prefixes A through L correspond to 1959, and the prefixes M through Y correspond with 1960. So the only people watching at this point who haven't got a date for their rifle are going to be those that don't have a State Arsenal 26 marking stamped into the receiver of their weapon, which can mean one of two things. First, and most obviously, there's a chance that your rifle wasn't manufactured by State Arsenal 26 and isn't covered by this video. If you check out my how-to video on identifying common SKS pattern carbine variants, you will likely find that your specific example is one of the many Chinese SKS pattern carbines that wasn't manufactured at State Arsenal 26, and you might even find that it's not Chinese to begin with. It's up to you to be diligent in ruling out these possibilities, as there are more than I can go into for this short walkthrough video. The second possibility, which is a pretty cool one, is that you're looking at one of the first approximately 200,000 Type 56 carbines ever produced in China in the years 1956 and part of 1957. These carbines will have the look, feel, and features of a non-refurbished late Tula SKS 45 with a 4, 5, or 6-digit numerical serial number with no triangle 26 stamping or Chinese characters. Subtle identification features are going to include the presence of what appears to be a birch stock as opposed to the far more common Chinese chewwood stock, and deep stamping on the serial numbers such that the shiny displaced metal contrast in a particular way compared to the deep bluing around it on the receiver. It's safe to assume that a 4 or 5-digit serial number rifle is going to be manufactured in 1956. However, if you've got a 6-digit serial number, it might be a 56 and it might be a 57, and I'm not sure that anybody knows exactly where that serial range lies. All right, everybody, that's the video, short and sweet. If this was helpful to you, go ahead and drop me a like. If it's interesting, go ahead and check out the other videos. If you have questions, love to see those in the comments. If you have suggestions, things you wish I would have done differently, or you're not sure that I got it right, love to see that in the comments as well. Otherwise, thanks so much for taking the time to check out this video, and I hope to catch you in the next one.